गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई विद्यासागर वेलकम यू ऑल इन द ई लर्निंग क्लास ऑफ मॉडर्न इंटरनेशनल टू दिस वन। आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट सब्जेक्ट हिस्ट्री ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 7 एंड दिस इज सिक्स्थ वीडियो लेक्चर ऑन द टॉपिक द मुगल एम्पायर चैप्टर 4। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द पॉलिसीज ऑफ द मुगल एम्पायर एंड हाउ द थॉट ऑफ द यूनिवर्सल पीस that was proclaimed by Akbar, which was considerably known as Sulh-e-Kul, and further it was also carried out by the Jahangir also. Now, the Mughal Empire in the 17th century and after. Dear students, the administrative and the military efficiency of Mughal Empire that led to great economic and commercial prosperity. It means the prosperity and the collection as well as the military's power, it all helps the Mughal Empire to collect the more and more revenues. Okay, the travelers, they described that it was the fabled land of wealth, but the same visitors, they have already explained it that the state of poverty also, okay, that existed side by side with the great opulence. It means further in the end of the till the when the Mughal Empire was in existing period, then it was fine, but after that the different type of poverty were seen also, the inequalities were glaring. Okay, like the document from the 20th century of Shah Jahan, Rizin informs the highest ranking Mansabdars were only of 445. The Mansabdars who were considered according to the Jat ranking in the Shah Jahan region, they were only 445 out of total 8000, and this number was only 5.6%. If you will find out the 5.6%, then it will be 445, and it received the 61.5% of total estimated revenues of empire as salary and themselves and also their troopers. The Mughal empires and their Mansabdars, they spent more deal of their income on salaries and goods. The expenditure benefited by the artisan and peasantry to whom the food and goods were supplied to them, but scale of the revenue collection left very for the investment in hand of primary producer. The peasants and the artisans, the poor among them, lived very quietly, spent their lives, and they don't have the money to invest on the tools to increase the productivity. The wealthier peasantries as well as the artisan groups, the merchant and bankers, they were basically profited in this economic world. The wealth resource commanded by the Mughal elite made them extremely powerful. It means those who were commanding it, it means those peoples who were powerful, they having the power, they used to command more wealth as in the late of 17th century, and the authorities of Mughal emperor slowly declined because the servant, they emerged as powerful as the new dynasty, and new commands of the province like Hyderabad, Awadh and Bengal were established. This was happened because their nobles, their loyals, they were establishing their own interest as well as they are also establishing set up their own dynasties. As to recognize the Mughal emperor in Delhi as their master, by the 18th century province of empire has consolidated their independent political identities. It means further they set up the new empire, and further they have also proclaimed themselves as independence identities. In the elsewhere of the world, you will see the kings and queens like In other part, in during the 16th century, the king of the Ottoman Turkey, who was Sultan Suleiman, during 1520 to 1566, during his rule, he expanded into Europe. He seized the Hungary and besieging the Austria also. His armies also seized Barak and Iraq and Baghdad and much of the North Africa. All the way into Morocco acknowledged the Ottoman authority. Suleiman also constructed the Ottoman's navy and its dominion over eastern Mediterranean brought the navy into competition with Spain. And in the Arabian Sea challenged the Portuguese also. The monarch was also given the title of Al-Kanuni because it was considered as lawgiver. Because many of the large number of regulation kanun were passed during his regency. And this was aimed to standardize the administrative procedure throughout the expanding dominions of empire, specifically to protect the peasantry from forced labor and extraordinary taxes. Later in 17th century, when public order declined in Ottoman dominance, the reign of Suleiman Kunen was remembered as period of idle governance. So what we can understood here, that any of the king, they having their own rules and regulation, wherever their thought is not usual same, wherever it is different, then the people, when the peoples they came to aware about it, they also used to find out. Okay, dear students, read the paragraph and keep watching. Thank you.